iOS 16 was just released and there's plenty of new features, but I'm not going to be focusing on the big major ones that everyone's been talking about, like being able to edit and unsend iMessages and customize the home screen. We've already heard about all that. I'm going to be focusing on features that are kind of hidden, maybe barely mentioned in the update log or not mentioned at all. And some of these are just little convenience features that I actually think are just as cool as the big new features. So let's just jump into it. So starting off, spammers are gonna hate this one. You can now report junk any type of spam text message. Before, you could only do it for iMessages, but now you can do it for regular SMS messages. So anytime you get a spam message, you should have that option to report junk now, and be sure to do that. It will help fight spam in the future because it reports it to both Apple and your carrier so they can improve their AI or whatever they use to detect these spammers. Next, this is one I've been waiting for. You can finally now enable haptic feedback and taps on the default iOS keyboard. So to do this, you go to the settings and then sound and haptics, keyboard feedback, and then enable haptic. And now when you type on the keyboard, it gives a little bit of feedback. And I just think that is so much better and nicer to use. Next, this small change is actually huge. You can now finally enable the battery percentage to show again. This one actually has been talked about a little bit more, but I just had to mention it. If you go into the battery settings, you can now finally have it show the actual percentage all the time at the top right. All right, so next I got a whole bunch of features all in a row having to do with photos. So the first one is now by default, the hidden and recently deleted albums in Photos is locked behind Face ID, which just makes total sense. If you are making a hidden album, it should be locked in some kind of way. There's also a new merge duplicate photos option. If you go to the albums menu and under utilities, it should be there, though it might not show up immediately. For me, it didn't really show up, even though I definitely put some duplicate photos in there. So maybe it just takes time to analyze. And how this works is if there are two photos that are detected to be identical and they're different qualities, it will always keep the higher quality one, so you don't have to worry about that. Next, you can now copy and paste edits of a photo. So if you've gone in and edited the lighting or whatever for a particular photo and you want to apply it to a whole bunch, you can now just long tap on it, hit copy edits, and then paste it onto another one or multiple. Also, now you can edit the metadata for multiple selected photos at once. So you could do this before for an individual video, but now you can select multiple and then, for example, change the date of a photo or all of them. So you just go to the bottom right little triple dot thing, and then it'll give you the same options that you could before with one photo, no matter how many you select. All right, now the final cool little one for photos is if you go to crop an image, there is now a new wallpaper aspect ratio option. So yeah, it automatically crops it if you go to select a wallpaper, but maybe you want to keep it cropped like that all the time. All right, moving on, the next feature is you are now able to view the passwords of Wi-Fi networks you have saved. So if you go to Wi-Fi and then click on the little info icon, you'll now have a new password field. So if you tap on that, it'll scan for Face ID to verify, and then it'll now show you that password for that network, and you can also tap to copy it if you want. Also in Wi-Fi, you are now able to edit all the Wi-Fi networks saved on the phone, not just ones that are showing within range. So to do that, at the top right of the Wi-Fi list, you hit edit, and it will immediately again scan for Face ID, and then now it will show a list of all the saved networks, not just the ones that are nearby. And then you'll have the same options that you usually do for those. All right, next up, we have a whole bunch of new features for contacts. Yes, you think, how can the contacts app have a bunch of new features? It does. First of all, this one's actually not so hidden because it'll literally show you, but you can now merge duplicate contacts automatically. If you're in contacts and it seems like as long as you're in the all contacts list, it will actually show a thing at the top that tells you that you have duplicate contacts and you can merge them. And also it just merges the cards, not technically the contacts behind the scene. So what I mean is if you have your list of contacts from iCloud and you have your list of contacts from Google, but before it was showing both lists, so it showed as duplicate, now it'll merge them into one card on your phone, but it'll still keep them in their respective lists. So it's not like you're deleting any contacts, it's actually just combining them to show on the phone. Also with contacts, the groups section has now been replaced with lists. And you can now finally create lists or previously groups on your actual iPhone and put contacts into them and then view only that list, for example. Before, you could create these groups, but you could only do it on the web, or I think maybe on a Mac. You couldn't do it on your phone, which was so stupid. But now you can do all of that. You can sort different contacts into lists, move them around. You can long press on a list to message or email them all. You can also rename and delete it, of course. Though one feature that was removed is you can no longer hide certain lists or groups from showing in your main contacts list. So before, if you showed all iCloud, you could actually unselect certain ones so they wouldn't show in your contacts list. You can't do that anymore. You can now either just show a single iCloud list or all of them, and that's it. Finally, for contacts, when you go to share a contact, you can now hit the filter fields option to select exactly what data you want to share with someone. So maybe you're sharing a friend's phone number, but you don't want to share their address or something. You can now just unselect that and only select what you want, and then send it to someone else. Now, sort of related to contacts, in iMessages, if you have dual SIM, you can now actually filter to only show contacts from one line or the other. So you can see here, there's primary, secondary. If you wanna only see the contacts from one, you can do that now. Next, another little feature, you can now add a quick note option to the control panel that swipes down. When you go to edit the control panel, that option will just be there to add. All right, the next feature is actually the ability to disable something, which is the behavior where if you're on a phone call, I didn't even know this. Apparently, if you hit the power button and lock the phone, it ends the call. I'm glad I never accidentally did that. But now you can actually disable that from happening. So what you do is go into accessibility settings and then touch and then enable prevent lock to end call. And now you can lock the phone, turn off the screen or whatever without ending the call. Next up, AirPods finally now have their own dedicated settings menu in the settings. So now if you have AirPods connected, whether that case is just open and the AirPods are still in there, or one AirPod is out, now if you go to the main settings list at the top, it'll show a thing for those AirPods. And you can now go in and do the usual stuff like seeing the battery percentage, changing whatever settings you want. Before, you would have to go all the way into like the Bluetooth settings. It was a pain. Now you don't have to worry about that. Okay, this next one is more of a behind the scenes thing, but you better still know about it. And that is the rapid security response feature. And I believe it's also on by default. Basically, under auto update, there's a new toggle for a rapid security response. And I would recommend you keep this on. Basically, it'll allow Apple to send out security only updates. So you can quickly get those installed automatically without necessarily having to do a whole update that requires you to restart the phone. It says some of them might still require you to restart the phone to complete an update, and it might just do that automatically while you're asleep or something, but I assume there will also be some that don't require you to do a restart at all. Next, we have a couple new features related to taking a screenshot. So now, right after you take a screenshot, if you want to go and share it by clicking the share button, you'll now see a new option to rename the file. So if you were to go to save it to files or email it or something, you can put in whatever name you want instead of screenshot and the time. Also, when you do hit done to save the screenshot, you now have a couple more options. One new option is to save it to a quick note. The other option is copy and delete. So this copies the image to the clipboard and then immediately deletes it. So this is good if you just want to quickly send a image to a friend to show them what you see without necessarily saving the whole image. Though the picture will still show up under recently deleted, so if you accidentally clear the clipboard before sending it and you want to get it back, you can still go and get it out of recently deleted. Next up, this has to do with the Files app. So in Files, you can now long press on a file and choose to remove download. And what this does is deletes the copy of the file from your local device, but keeps it on iCloud. So you'll notice that after you do that, the little download icon appears on the file. So this is good if you have a bunch of big files you don't need to access right away. You can just store them in the cloud. All right, now finally, these next few features are a little bit more well-known, but I figured I'd share them in case you don't know about them. First, you'll see that if you open up the Mail app, it'll tell you that there's a new feature to undo send within about 10 seconds. But what you might not know is you can actually increase that time delay. So if you go into settings and then the Mail app settings, you'll see that there is an option to go up to 30 seconds and you can cancel sending that message within that time if you want. Also in the weather app, before you could only see the hourly forecast for the current day, but now if you tap on any day, it'll show you a much more detailed forecast even than what we had before, and it's for any day of the week. So you can now see a lot more info through the weather app. All right, now finally is the passkey feature. And this one deserves really its own video, but I thought I'd quickly mention it so you at least know about it. Basically, this is a new security protocol that a lot of companies are probably gonna be adopting, and it basically allows you to log into websites and services without using a password at all. It basically uses like the security chip within your phone, so it should be theoretically unphishable and unstealable to prevent scammers and hackers from accessing your account. There is way more to it, but I'm not gonna get into all that, and you won't see this right away for many websites. They will probably start adding this feature over time though. So if you found this video helpful, the next one I'd recommend is where I talked about 10 computer security myths that you should stop believing. I'll put that link right there. Also, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know in the comments. Maybe if I missed any super hidden features, you can let us know down there. And of course, if you want to subscribe, also click the bell to enable notifications. And thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.